Shalom Abracha, good morning, Ahuvai Vareai. Let's turn back to this past week's Parsha, Parshas Vayelech. And of course, we know that one of the centerpieces of this very short Parsha, the shortest of all the Parshios HaTorah, Parshas Vayelech, all of 30 psukim in Parshas Vayelech, revolving very much around Mitzvahs Hakel. Hakel es Anoshim es Anoshim es Ataf. So let's take a look at a well-known Gemara in Meseches Chagiga. Chagiga Daf Gimel Amud Aleph. And the Gemara says as follows, citing a Braisa. There was a Maisa, Rav Yochanan ben Baruch and Rav Elazar, Rechisma, Shahochu Lahagwa Pnei Rabbi Yeshua Bibaki, and they went to be Makalo Pnei Rabbam Rabbi Yeshua. Amrulam Machinish Ayom Beis HaMedrash. What chiddush was there today in the Beis HaMedrash? Shamalo Tamidecha Anu Memecha Anu Shaisen. We your Tamidim. We came to hear you. We want to drink from your Torah Dika waters. Amar Lam Afa Pikein. He Efshar LeBeis HaMedrash Bli Chiddush. There's got to be a chiddush. You got to tell me something new. Parenthetically, Rav Avram Shur said at his Beis Knesset's dinner a few years ago, he said an interesting homiletic take on Ein Beis Medrash Bli Chiddush. You want to keep up with Shein Beis Medrash, you want to be Mamshech the Shein Beis Medrash Beis Knesset's, then you always need to be Machadish. You always need to create new programs, new shiurim. You want to keep up the Gevaldige Shein, always have to go weiter, Mechoy Elochoy, creating ever new programs, events, shiur Mechadayma. But again, Pasha said to Gemara, Ein Beis Medrash Bli Chiddush, Yevshu Le Beis Medrash, you got to tell me there's got to be something new. So the Gemara says, Shabbos Shomi Haisa, I was on Gamliya, Lozum Nazariah, the whole Sigyan Bukhus Chavches, I was the Shabbos Lozum Nazariah. So what did he darshan in? Mitzvah Sakel, Parshas Vayela, Chamad Dorishba, Hakeles, Alma Noshami, Anoshami Ataf, Emma Noshim Boyim Limut, Vinoshim Boz, the Shmo Taflam, a Boyim. What are you bringing the kids for? Kade Lahavi Schar and Mevian. In order to bring, to add on Schar to those who bring these young children, Big Dean and the Rishonim, and Achonim, whom exactly do we put under that category of taf? What age? That's a whole big discussion. Al kaponim, why are they coming? Kedei lahavi schar lemevi'ein. He's so nispoil. Amar la margalus toiva haisa v'yerchem v'kashto lami medi. Such a margalus, such a precious pearl. Ay, such a jewel you had in your hands and you weren't going to share with me. So agav, let's pause with the Yad Ramon Sanhedrin afnun amad beiz. Yad Ramon says, oftentimes we encounter in Shas the loshin meragli b'pumei. And again, Poshub Shat, the Meragli B'Pumei, indicates a lotion of Hergel, that this Tana, this Amora, would often say such a thing, similar to Amei Shapiro Milo Blin in the Chavetz Chaim, on the pages of Pirkei Avos, Hu Hayo Omer. What does it mean, Hu Hayo? He used to say, no, Hu Hayo Kamo Shai Omer. He was in accordance with the credo by which he lived. This statement defined his life, defined his MO, his modus operandi, defined his core essence. That's Hu Hayo Omer, Hu Hayo Kamo Shai Omer. So what's Meragli B'Pume? He said it, Meragli, he said it so often. And this was his Mimer Kilu. I know adds the Arama, but why was that the case? Why did this individual, why did Plony say this Mimer so repeatedly? Answer is because Meragli, Loshin Margulis, he viewed it like a precious pearl. If you view something like a pearl, like a Margulis, then the Mela, are you going to say it all the time when they ask the Chsam Sefer, how is it your father, the Chsam Sefer, the Goladar, has such an unbelievable memory? How does he do it? He says it's not that he has an otherworldly memory. It's at the Chassam Sefer. Every word of Torah, every line in Torah. I was mamish, he was in a spoil, margulis. Same way if you read all the memory books, George Lucas, Harry Lorraine, Joshua Fuller, I'm all moonwalking with Einstein, all these great books of memory, so much of association when you associate ideas, names, facts, and figures to crazy, to wild imagery. Children, Gerson Yankusa, so oftentimes remember things. Why? Because they're in a spoil. And when they see something unusual, something out of the ordinary, Zuknik Sam Sefer, the Tati, Sam Sefer, every word of Torah was Mamisha Margulis. It was a diamond, it was a gem, it was a precious billion-dollar jewel. He couldn't forget it. It wasn't shocking. By him, it was Mamish the Yad Ramos and Hedjanun of a base because it was a Margulis. And a Mela Maragli Bapume. Ah, that's the Yad Ramos, Sanhedrin Afanun of a base. But we have to stop and ask this question. He is so nispo, such a tifazach, such a profound vart. Ah, Anoshim Bom Lumod. And the men are coming to learn. Venoshim Bos Lashmo, they're not coming to learn. Kedushim Chamtesim and base. A woman of Paturis in the midst of Talmud Torah, the Paturis to give over Torah to the next generation, and they're exempt from being taught the Torah threefold. Exempt exception based on the matamosus benechem benechem lo benasechem. I in the dorshas chazal kedushin chavtesim and base. So why are they coming? No shimbos l'shmoa. About it, we still want them here, very integral to the Chinuch Ayin Rezalman Sarovskin and Chuvus Masnayim Lemishbar Chelik Beisim and Men Beis. So about it, we have the woman coming there, coming to hear, not coming to learn. V'taf, and why are the children coming to go in and add the schar? So again, many different vertelach. We have the famous Chidon, his Kisei Rachamim, on Masecha Sofrim, on this Braisa, and Perikid Cheshwa, the Chidon writes, and the Ben Yoda says the same shtickle, that we have the Gemara and Brochus, Tafavim, Beis, Igrit, Kala, Duchgen, the schar of the Yarchei Kala, is the doichik is sitting squashed since you get schar the fum tzara agra, the last mission that fit parke parke yomis, in accordance with the pain, with the difficulty, that's what's marba, that's what augments and intensifies the schar. The more children you bring, the more squashed you're going to sit. Aye, what do you mean? Beis HaMikdash mission of parke yomis, parke mission hey, on its fuch, mishdachim revochim, yeah, that's b'shas l'shtachavoya pa b'shas l'yamida on its fufim, we were standing squashed until it came time to the achra and the ashtachavoya. So, the more kids you bring, the more squashed we're going to be, the more squashed we are, the more schar we get, we're going to call it duchka. That's the chidah. That's the Ben Yoyada. Then, of course, we have the famous Nesivus of Yaakov Elisa. And his Nesivus, he's bought by Rabbi Yosef Engel, says he saw it also in the name of the Arizal, Tzeda Lederach, and many others for him also bring him a shame, the Ariya Kaddish. Arizal says, what's the schar? Well, if the fathers have to go because they have to go Lumud, and the mothers have to go because they have to go Lashma, who's going to babysit? All the men have to go and all the women have to go. Avister says, you know what? I know my mother Shuch, you're going to have to bring the children up with you to Yerushalayim. But you know what? I love you so much. And Amar Chanina, Kedusha Laman Aleph, Laman Aleph, Godu Mitzvah V'Yosef. I mean, Shein Mitzvah V'Yosef. I want to increase your schar. Hey, Mr. loves us so much. I want to give you even more schar. So the men have to go, Baim Limud, and the women have to go, Baus L'Shmoa. What are you going to do with the children? No one's around to babysit. They're all going up to Yerushalayim. You can't leave the kids alone at home. And the other, you're right. You're going to bring with you. Hashem says, you know what? You're bringing them. Let me give you more schar. Let me give you Nocha Mitzvah. Azok the Arizah, Azok the Nesivus. I'm going to add onto your schar, and I'm going to tell you, you know what? Bring the taf miman of shach. So, many different vertlach we have Rav Hunder, so many different mahalchim to understand how we magdid this schar lemeviyayin. But we have to ask the question. Here's Rabbi Yeshua, two talmidim come and visit him at Bekiyin, and he says, Nu, we have shul lebeis menesh v'lo chiddush. They tell him, Ano shimbom limo, no shimos v'shvo taf lemabom, kiri labi schar lemeviyayin. Rabbi say, what's the tivazach? What's so margulis taiva haisa b'yerchav v'kash labi m'meni? What in the world's going on here? Why is Rabbi Shua so nispal? This isn't the deepest, most profound vart we've ever seen in the pages of Chazal. Listen to a vart that's cited by the Ben Yoyada, cited by the Sefer at Divrei Emes, cited by the Maral Mintz in his Perush of Perkei Avos Parak Beis Mishnah Ches Asher Yeladato, cited by the Meshech Chochma Rameyah Simcha for Novitzka in the pages of his Meshech Chochma in this past week's Parsha Parsha Ve'ilech. And I saw the same shtickle by the Aderes of Elio David Rabinowitz to Umim. He writes the same shtickle in his Kuncha Zeicher LeMikdash Amitzas Hakav Daflam and Gimel. See, have a Ben Yoyada Divrei Emes Amaral Mintz Ameshech Chochma and Aderes Zeicher LeMikdash. Listen to this Gavaldige shtickle. What do we know about the Rabbi Yeshua? Let's go to the pages. Is a perkei of his perk base mishnah ches Rabbi Yochanan Zaka Chamisha Taminim Hayilon Yochanan Zaka, and one of them is Yeshua ben Chananya, and that is this Rabbi Yeshua Stam Rabbi Yeshua Yeshua ben Chananya. And what was the praise? Say Ayamon Mem Shimchani, would extol the virtues of all his respective close five disciples. And what comment did he have to say about his close Talmud Rabbi Yeshua? Asher Yeladato, praiseworthy is the mother, the Yiddish Mama, who gave birth to such a child. So what's going on over here? Along comes Rav Hajim Bar Tanura. The Rav writes in his base on the Yushalmi and Yavamas Park Aleph, Brysa Halochahe. And the Yushalmi says that when he was born, again, different Nisra, some say that she would go around already when she was pregnant, others, Mato Barasa, so when he was in the crib, in the stroller, she would take her young little infant who wasn't capable of chopping tighter before he was able to speak, before anything, either when she was still pregnant, according to some Nisra's, but otherwise, when he was a newborn infant, what would she do? She'd go to the Bate Knesis and the Bate Menorahs, and she would want him to hear Kol HaTaira, Kol HaTfila. She wanted him to be kolay, to absorb and hear nothing outside of Kedushas HaTaira and Kedushas HaTfila. Amela, he says, why did I become Rabbi Yeshua? Because my mother took me already at a young age and exposed me only to Dvarim Shel Kedusha, to Torah, to Tefillah, always keeping me in proximity to the Beis Knesset or the Beis Medrash. Amela, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, his Rebbe knew the secret to his success, and thus what did he call out? Not his own godless, but the godless of his mother, as the Taminim of the Gross and many other Gedolim said. We're not the Mekane. It was Olam Haba, we're Mekane even more than the Vilna Gaon's Olam Haba, or Mekane, the Olam Haba of the Vilna Gaon's mother. Imagine the Vilna Gaon's mother who raised the Vilna Gaon and was Moshe Nevis for the Vilna Gaon. Imagine her Olam Haba. Noshma Yzachin, Brochus Yitzayin Tzot Chaval, if I could upon him. That's the Gevaldiga, Gevaldiga, Hamayla, that Asher Yelanato. Imagine the Sina Shemama taking Rabbi Yeshua as a mere infant and having him only be Kolei Devrei Torah, Devrei Tefillah. Asher Yelanato, Zogta Bar Tanura. That was the praise. The praise was because he was already the young child. Hamayla, we come back to our Gemara Chagigat of Gimel and Aleph, and his two Tamidim say the Drosh of Rolazim and Azariah. Why do you bring the Taf to Mitzvah Hakel? Taf Lamabom Kedei Lahavi Schel Mevet. What are you bringing the Taf for? What's the Gemara's Kasha? They're not going to gain anything. And then they don't know what's going on, these young children. Even Ezra says they're even called taf. Why? Because they're mataf taf, like a running drip of water. It's meant to drip. So little kids, they take itsy bitsy steps. They're mataf taf. They walk in itsy, they're barely walking. Taf, mataf taf. These young children, they're not absorbing the words of the Torah. So why are you bringing them? Can Avi so that all the parents can be together? Asher Yeladato. So bring the young children so that already at a young age, the age of infancy, in their mere fledgling years, bring them already in proximity to the vicinity of Mitzvah Haka by the Beis HaMikdash, and let them hear the Melech read Mishnah Torah, let them hear him read Sefer Dvarim, let them absorb the words of Torah, everyone, the experience, the spiritual ruchniistic infused experience of God's Klaus HaBiyachad, as Avunah says, based on the Rambam, Helchus Beis HaMachir and Gimel Gimel, it's a reenactment, a re-experience, Kilu, HaBachinim Ein of Maimon HaSinai, Moshe on top, Klaus all encircling here, Lahavdol the Melech on top, here we are reenacting Maimon HaSinai. Let the child be part of the experience. You'll give more schar to the parents. You'll see unbelievable Yiddish nachas as the child gets older. You wanted to rob me of such a gem, of such a diamond, such a pearl. How'd you want to take it away? I'm a shechok ma'aderes. Marantz, why was he so in this way? Because he was that child. He was the child. It was an Asher Yeladato child. He was a child taken already when he was a young tough. And look what became of him. All because of hearing and being kolei those powerful words of Tyrant Fila at a young age when he didn't chop, he didn't intellectually grasp one iota. But in the end of the day, and as Ashpa, it's mashpi on you. The same Chido says, have a Zohar in your house. Just having a Zohar in the house is already going to be a Gevaldig Ashpa. Yi Beischa, Beisval HaChacham, Rav Chaim Elosh, and Ruach Chaim, and Rav Avram Achia Grod, Perkei Avraham. If you can't have Tamid HaChacham in the house, at least bring this farm. Just having this farm, fill this farm in the house, is a Gevaldig Ashpa. Imagine you bring a child to Hakel, even if they're not collate, they don't absorb anything. They get a Gevaldig Ashpa. That's Asher Yeladato. That's Margulis time of Haisim Yechel. That's Davka Rabbi Yeshua. Leshita so, because that summed up his Nekudas Egadlus. That in fact heightened up his greatness. That was his VIP pass. That's why he was so spoiled. So let's just close with the Gevaldig Gevort. Tishtel Tzu, Rav Shimon Schwab, and Mayim Beishoi, and Moshe Feinstein, and Drash Moshe. We know that when it came to the count in Parshas Bamidbar and Nosso, we counted Klal Yisrael, we counted them 20 to 60. 20. Yoroi Lutzava, Ben Esrom Lirdo, Mishnah Nova, Seichav Aleph. That's when you went out to get married too. Sustain yourself, have your own livelihood. It's Yosef, and if Yosef, that's 20 years old, 60 already, been teaching the Zingna. So when it came to Sheva Levi, Frek de Velta Kasha, if you're counting Klaiso between 20 to 60, why is Sheva Levi ready to be Mechodesh Lamala? Why are they counting at such a young age? We can't count them the second they're born. But once at 30 days, Shabbos Kaflam and Hamad Bezer, Shingam Leo, they're already Mufka from Cheskas and Eiffel. They're not deemed a miscarriage, as the Gross says, you're only called a Ben or Bas. Once you're Mufka from Cheskas and Eiffel, now you're 30 days old. So once a Ben Levi is 30 days old, he's no longer viewed as a possible miscarriage. Now we call him a Ben Abbas. He's an upstanding member of Sheva Levi. Frek de Velta Kasha, Moshe Feinstein, Shimon Schwab, and others. Why are we counting them in Ben Chodesh Lamala? Everybody else, we have to wait until 20. Along comes Moshe, Shimon Schwab, Bechodem Machse Machsinu. Everybody else, you know what? You're so influenced by society around you. We don't know how you're going to turn out, but once you get to 20 years old, on the same as Shabbos Peites and Beis, when are you chayim misa midei shamayim? When you're 20 years old. That's when, in fact, there was an old study done many years ago that the brain, which is the most complex organ in the entire, most complex entity in the entire universe, the brain is the last organ to fully develop and mature. You have the cortical plasticity and the neuron connections that are still taking place until 20 years old. It doesn't reach its hashem until you get to 20, makes sense, until that higher dark of 20 years old. Say every other member of Klai, so you gotta wait until the 20. Are they a Ben Taira? Which Mahala? The Ben Aliyah? What Mahala are they espousing in life? I but a Ben Levi. His whole life is Kedusha. He's growing up in proximity to the Beis HaMikdash. He's in proximity in a short radius around the center of Kedusha, the eye of the universe. Baba Masud of Dalan Amalvi, he's Mamish, and the Ein HaOlam, he's in the Makor HaKedusha, the Gansavel. Ben Levi, you don't have to wait until 20. You don't even have to wait until Bar Mitzvah. The second of Ben Levi is Mufka from Cheskes Nefil. Ben Levi is already 30 days old. He's growing up in proximity to a Beis HaMikdash, the Mokum HaVodah, the Mokum HaTfilah, the Mokum HaTaira, Lishkas HaSanhedrin, the Sanhedrin. You don't have to worry about him. You don't have to wait until his Bar Mitzvah. You don't have to wait until 20 for all the speeches and all the Pshetalach. How's he turning out all the Milas the second he's 30 days old? Count them already as an upstanding member of Sheva Levi, because you can rest assured he's going to turn out just fine. Rabbi said that's the hashpa. Make sure, take your children, give them that hashpa. Well, let them only be exposed to Kol HaTorah, Kol HaTfilah. You don't think they're mushpa? Everybody is mushpa. Whether consciously or subconsciously, there's always that hashpa that's prevalent around us. Yom V'Layla, never stop thinking. All the hashpa is there. Make sure to expose your children and indeed yourselves only to Dvar Mishal Kedusha. Have a gavaldig day and a great last week of the year.